Hey everyone, I'm Dr. Amna Hussain, board certified pediatrician, board certified lactation consultant, and mom. I've done a video like this in the past and I said, not mom to one, but mom to two. So here we go, let's do our second round and say not mom to two, but soon to be mom to three. So last time I did a pregnancy Q&A, I had a lot of fun answering your guys' questions, and it's one of the most popular videos on the channel. I'm happy to go through it again because I feel like last time COVID was going on and we had like a dedicated video just about COVID and pregnancy because I did actually contract COVID during that pregnancy before the vaccine was even available. This time, there's a lot of other things going around. We're talking about concerns of genocide, we're talking about measles outbreaks, and just generally a lot of questions that you guys have asked about how do I feel about number three. So let's get right in. So how am I doing overall? This has been a tough pregnancy. This has been, I would say, my toughest pregnancy. I do like to obviously keep some personal information to myself, but perhaps it's my age, perhaps it's just two kids to take care of at home. Perhaps it is also just like a lot of other stuff going on in the background. As you guys know, we did recently move. We moved from New Jersey to North Carolina, which is my home state. And we were building a house. So before the house was done, we were renting. And we lived kind of, I would say a few boxes. I planned that we would be, you know, keeping some stuff packed away. But then as we moved into our new home, build, and it was all very exciting. Obviously, a lot more unpacking and just kind of managing new transitions for the kids. I've done a lot of videos in the past, which I can link some right here, on how to help children with moving. I've also discussed about how to help children with new transitions, and I feel like all of those tips kind of played in, and it's been a lot, which means that unfortunately, we moms end up putting ourselves on the back burner, and doing that during pregnancy isn't always feasible. Which brings me to my next question. How are we feeling with number three? Are we ready? How does this pregnancy feel different? So I feel like this is gonna be different for everybody because, you know, our family, you know, is ready for number three. I came from a family of four girls. My husband came from a family of three boys. So just because we had multiple siblings doesn't mean that I feel for any reason you have to have multiple siblings, but it was a good decision for us. And I did get a few questions that, like, you know, I'm ready for a third, but my husband's hesitant. And I will say, as a pediatrician, I really do believe that both parents should be on the same page, definitely for your support system. That's very helpful. But also just for the child. I mean, of course, things happen and feelings develop along the way, feelings of love, feelings of acceptance and support. But I do feel like that helps in some ways. And everybody's situation is different, right? So I think that plays a big part as well. So in the most roundabout way, how are we feeling about number three? Overwhelmed, but excited. So on that note, we are about second trimester in, so we're in that honeymoon period. It's definitely been a rough pregnancy, and I will say that I've told you guys in the past that I do have a little bit more difficult pregnancies. I have migraines at baseline. Those get more difficult in pregnancy, especially because some of the medicines are changed and moved around. I will also mention that I have heartburn in pregnancy. That's really annoying. This time around, I have felt a little bit more of nausea and vomiting. This time around, going through a pregnancy with two kids is definitely a bit different. If I want to take a nap, I can't always time it with one of the children because my oldest doesn't nap anymore, so it's not exactly easy to get the rest when you want to get the rest. And I feel like that was different with most people's first pregnancy. I was in residency, but I only had me to take care of. With my second pregnancy, I did try to nap when my oldest napped. So it has been a little bit of a growing curve, literally and figuratively, to figure out kind of the best management strategy. Some days are better than other days, and I feel like that goes to be said for almost every pregnancy. how are these pregnancy symptoms been different from any other child? I will say that I've been very, very lucky with my first two pregnancies that the nausea really is what I kind of experienced, but then I didn't vomit that often. I had a very strong gag reflex, which is very normal, so sometimes I would vomit while brushing my teeth or brushing my tongue, but I didn't vomit a lot. Unfortunately, in this pregnancy, I did catch a cold and I felt like my asthma flared a lot, so every coughing fit did trigger vomiting, and that was pretty difficult, I feel like, especially because obviously managing two kids and then throwing up, that was not easy. And then on top of that, not feeling well with the asthma, that was kind of a big part of like the initial part of this pregnancy. That seems to be better now. Migraines are still kind of something I deal with pretty extensively through each pregnancy, and the heartburn, obviously, which isn't great either. But other than that, I mean, I think that every pregnancy is a little different, and definitely having the two older kiddos has been nice because they're so sweet and so helpful and so excited. But also, it's tough because you obviously want to take care of them before you take care of yourself, which is kind of the anthem of being a mom, I feel like. So speaking of, let's talk about how the girls are feeling about adding a sibling. They are so, so excited. Like, I couldn't have planned their emotions and their reactions and their feedback any better. They are very, very excited. So right now I have a 3.5 year age gap between my oldest and my second, and between the second and the third, it'll be about a 3 year age gap. So I'm really happy with that age gap, thankfully. But I do think it helps to be able to reason a little bit with my current second year old, who's my youngest, and be able to talk to her. Of course, every child's different. Being able to coach my oldest that a new baby was coming was very different than being able to coach baby, you know, little one number two right now. But it really couldn't be a better situation. The two girls are very, very excited right now. So let's talk about my favorite thing about being pregnant and my least favorite thing. And I kind of love this question because I don't think I had this question last time. So my least favorite thing is the physical symptoms. So all that back pain started so early before I even started showing. And I think it really just has to do with ligament laxity. So ligaments hold our bones together, and you know, they've already separated once in my low back and pelvic area for two babies, so they already knew what to do. So before I even started showing, I started feeling back pain and that sacral pain and sciatic pain, which was not great, but I already started feeling those symptoms. I think the migraine symptoms, which I've hit on, those are things that I can definitely do without, because my triggers are usually lack of sleep, not, you know, being able to eat or drink regularly, and all of those things. The lack of sleep especially happens a lot in pregnancy. Not being able to eat on time or drink as much as I'd like, that happens just being a mom. So all of those just like typical symptoms that you hear about in pregnancy, I would feel like those are my least favorite things. I would say my favorite thing, and I don't know if I'm allowed to have two, but I'm going to give myself two. My favorite thing is getting a chance to feel the baby move. I feel like that is a really, just like a blessing for a parent. You know, you're able to keep your baby protected, obviously, and safe, but your thoughts are always on them. And, you know, you kind of feel that movement as a reassurance. And I would say my second favorite thing, kind of tied with the first, is seeing the girls' reactions. I feel like it just brings so much warmth to my heart that I couldn't have imagined before. I think it's very different being a parent and being excited about a pregnancy, and it's very different being a parent and seeing your other children excited about a pregnancy. It makes you feel like, gosh, maybe you're like doing something right, or maybe you were, you know, raised them to have so much compassion and love, and so that feels really good to me. So have I been, I'm gonna switch gears a little bit and go in a very slightly superficial direction, since we talked about our children and excitement and everything about the pregnancy. Let's switch gears, because I get this question a lot. Have I been working out during pregnancy? I've also had questions about when do you start lifting or stop lifting your children, etc. I will say that I am not your OBGYN provider. I'm not a physician who takes care of pregnant women exclusively, so I can't provide medical advice. I'll say that I have exercised on days that feel good to me, where I feel up to it. It's been a little bit harder this pregnancy simply because with the asthma, the shortness of breath did not make exercise very feasible, nor do I try to make it. And obviously, if I don't feel really great, I may not be exercising. On the flip side of that, when I don't exercise, all that back pain, hip pain, joint pain really does, you know, resurface and make itself feel worse. So I feel like it's a double-edged sword. While there's days where I definitely have trouble fitting it in, I do know it helps me a lot more. Similar to my last pregnancy, I've been seeing a physical therapist pretty early on because I did start feeling those back pains really early. And I would say that all of those together, I do feel like are helping, but it is harder to exercise this pregnancy. I have been taking modifications and working with a physical therapist who's well-versed in prenatal fitness, but also just like the ways your bodies change with ligaments, with pelvic floor, with core work during pregnancy. I think that has helped a lot too. Now, one question I commonly get is, as I'm adding more children, like, am I more stressed? How is it in a dual physician household? And I will say that managing work and life as a balance is kind of a myth, I strongly believe. I do think that it's not a balance. It's definitely not 50-50. It's not equal. There are times where one will take priority over the other, and that's okay. And the other thing is I work in healthcare, so there's some flexibility there because I'm self-employed, but there's less flexibility there because I work in healthcare. It's kind of about what I choose to make a priority, and I feel that not everybody's household is going to be exactly the same. I am kind of the parent on call, so if emergency arises, etc., I'm kind of the one who is able to be there for the kiddos. That being said, if I'm traveling or if I'm busy with work or if I have patients that are scheduled, then my husband picks up that role. And that's just the way it's supposed to be. You know, we're equal parents. Our duties are split up, not necessarily evenly, but our duties are split up. And I think that it's really, it's not like an easy answer to say that this is just a balance that's achieved and I have the answer to it and I've unlocked the secret. Outsourcing helps, having a support system helps. And again, trying to figure out what recharges your batteries or how to be the best mom and the best person for yourself really is the key, and that can be a moving target, right? You know, being a good mom to one child when they're 3 months old is very different than being a mom to two children when they are 6 and 2, or being a mom to two children and pregnant, because then you also kind of are prioritizing how you're feeling as well, because you can't control those things. I know that's not a great answer. I do want to point out though that I've gotten a lot of questions about, like, is it a good time to get pregnant if you're in medical school? And I will say that the best time to get pregnant is when you feel like it's right for you. That's really all. You're going to feel a lot of people telling you when to have children, how to have children, asking you personal questions about age differences, etc. I mean, I got a ton of questions just putting out a question box, and I went through and I didn't answer all of them. Some of them are a little too personal and some of them are out of my scope of practice. But I will say that it has to feel right to you at the end of the day. Our lives change in a big way when we become parents, and it's a big undertaking and it has to feel right. I hope that was helpful. I am happy to answer any other questions that you leave in the comments below. Again, I would say this pregnancy is sort of a moving target because you hear me already short of breath. All of those symptoms started so early in this pregnancy with the baby and all of, you know, what my body knew what to do the third time around. But I'm happy to answer any questions that you guys leave in the comments. Let me know if there's anything you'd like to see more of. I am happy to brainstorm and think of more prenatal and pregnancy content. Last time we did, epidurals. We talked about and how they affect the baby. We talked about what I'm packing in my hospital bag. And so I'm happy to, again, think of content with you guys. If this video was helpful, give it 2 thumbs up and make sure you come back for the next round of questions that we're answering about pregnancy. Bye.